Hi, we're here on the pier of the Inter-University Institute for Marine Sciences in Eilat. And I am with Professor Amatzia Ganin, who is the manager of this institute, and who will now tell us about the institute and about the production of fish.
Thank you, Michal. It's perhaps relevant to mention that I'm a marine ecologist, and I'm also a faculty member at the Hebrew University. And I'm here already 30 years, and I'm now the director of this institute, which is a very unique institute that is managed by all the universities in Israel, open for all the students from the country and from abroad for inter-university courses. And people from all over the country and many visitors from many countries come here to do their research in the coral reef and also in the deep water not too far from here. Coral reef fishes reproduce in a very unique way, and I would say that perhaps the most unique feature of their reproduction is their change of sex. They change sex. They become males after being females, or vice versa, become females after they had been males for some time. Sex change in fish was discovered for the first time here, not far from us. Professor Lev Fishelson from Tel Aviv University was following one type of fish called antias, reef antias. It's a very common species here, found over knolls and corals, found all across the Gulf of Eilat and Aqaba and into the Indian Ocean and Pacific Ocean. And the fish live in social groups. Each fish reproduces within this group. And it turns out that there is a certain ratio, more or less, one male to seven females. And how do they keep this ratio? Because fish die. So when a male dies, let's say it got eaten by a big predator or something like that, and disappears, the largest female changes its sex and becomes a male within days. Within 2 weeks, it's fully male, functioning as a male, looks like a male. Looking like a male means body size is larger, different fins, different colors, so morphological and certainly physiological changes and reproduction changes. For us, it was enigmatic. Like, the largest fish, the largest female, will change its sex. Why would they change the sex to males when they are very large? Because in fish, like in insects and other many animals, snails and others, the larger the body size, the more eggs they produce, not the more sperms, because sperms are not limited by the size of the individual. So it makes sense that animals will change their sex as they grow, from being males at the beginning to become females at larger size. How can we explain that enigmatic change of sex? It all depends on the fact, or it's due to the fact, that these fish reproduce in social groups. And now we know that that change, sex change from females to males, occur in many species that live in social groups in the coral reef. And where is the difference? The difference is that if you are a large male, females would come and mate with you, not with a smaller fish. So where do we find the other sex change from being a male as a small one to become a female as a large one? We find it in fish and many other animals that their reproduction is not social. They reproduce en masse. Like, it's not that females choose males or vice versa. They just go there and reproduce without selection. And there, of course, it's beneficial or it's adaptive to become a female when you are large. And we see that in many other fish that do not reproduce socially. Now, these are the two types of reproduction that we can see here in the coral reef.